friends. Do you remember a time when God answered your prayers? Sometimes God answered your prayers right away. Other times God may not answer your prayers immediately. And sometimes God doesn't always say yes to your prayers. But what's important and true is that God hears and God answers. It was late at night in Jerusalem and everyone was asleep except for one house. All the houses were dark except for the house of a woman named Mary. A group of Christians who were friends of Peter had gathered there. Something terrible had happened, and there was only one thing these Christians can do. They were praying for God's help. Meanwhile, Peter continued to tell people the good news of Jesus, and many came to believe. However, King Herod wanted the Christians to stop telling people about Jesus. He had arrested several Christians and even had one of them named James put to death. Then the terrible news came. Peter had been arrested just for telling people that Jesus had died on the cross for their sins. King Herod wanted to make sure Peter would not escape. So he ordered 16 men to guard Peter, four at a time. Two guards were chained to Peter's wrists while two more men guarded the prison door. They had strict orders not to let Peter escape or they would be punished by death. Outside Peter's prison cell, a big iron gate was locked so no prisoner could escape. Herod's plan was to have Peter put to death the next day. He knew this would please the Jewish leaders who didn't believe on Jesus. How do you think Peter felt? Would you be scared and trembling in fear? The Bible says Peter was sound asleep, even chained to his guards. Peter knew he could trust God to do what was best, so he slept peacefully. I would be terrified and I would be so nervous and I would be crying, asking God for help. But Peter trusted, so he had peace in his heart. But Peter's Christian friends who were gathered at the house of Mary, they were so worried, so they stayed up all night praying for God to save Peter. This seemed like an impossible situation because there were 16 men, four at a time, rotating, guarding Peter, and he was chained. And how will he escape? How would he be saved? But they prayed to God, believing God would hear and answer. So as Peter slept, suddenly something amazing happened. The Bible says an angel of the Lord appeared and a light shone in the cell. He struck Peter on the side and woke him up. "Quick, get up," he said, and the chains fell off of Peter's wrists. The angel ordered, "Get up, put on your robe and sandals." Peter obeyed, still unsure of what was happening. He got up and followed the angel, thinking he was still dreaming. Peter and the angel walked right past the guards unseen. When they reached the big iron gate that was locked, it swung right open for them. Peter and the angel walked through the open gate and down the dark street. Then the angel disappeared and Peter was alone. Now Peter was fully awake. He realized what had just happened. God had sent an angel and freed him from prison. Peter hurried to Mary's house to be with his friends. At Mary's house, the Christians were still praying that God would help their friend Peter. A girl named Rhoda was praying with them when she heard a knock at the door. She went to the door but was probably afraid to open it since Herod's soldiers could be there looking for more Christians. So she cautiously listened. Peter spoke and probably said something like, "Hey, it's me, open the door." Rhoda recognized Peter's voice, but could it really be him? Rhoda was so excited that she ran to tell the others about the good news, but in her hurry, she forgot about Peter and left him standing outside the locked door. Rhoda announced to the other Christians, "Hey guys, Peter is here. He's standing right outside." The other Christians looked at each other like, "Rhoda, are you imagining things? It can't be Peter. He's in prison. Remember, that's why we're here praying. You're crazy." They didn't believe God had already heard and answered their prayers. But Peter kept on knocking, and soon they all heard him. They rushed to the door and opened it. Everyone was delighted to see Peter and amazed at the power of God. Peter motioned them to be quiet. Then he told his friends how God had sent an angel to free him from prison in answer to their prayers. Knowing it would soon be daylight and Herod would be searching for him, Peter left the city to be safe. The next day, King Herod was furious and couldn't imagine how Peter had escaped. He said it was impossible, but you know, we know the truth. Nothing is impossible for God. God heard and answered when Peter's friends prayed. Do you believe that God hears and answers your prayers? It's not that our prayers are powerful, but it is God who is powerful to answer our prayers. Remember that next time when you pray, God hears, God answers.